Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm painting this fairy house with gouache, and I don't know it's a fairy house or not, but I found this reference picture on Pinterest, and as soon as I saw it I thought it's a scene from fairy tale. I mean, the picture gives a fantasy kind of vibe and I wanted to paint that. I'll link the pin in the description if any of you guys wanted to see it, and I hope you enjoyed the painting process. So these past few days have been a really hectic time. Doing all of my studies and painting at the same time, it was really overwhelming. I mean, this painting took me almost 3 weeks to finish, and it's been so hard to keep up with the work and painting, editing. I mean, the whole process of uploading videos and keeping an online presence at the same time. Honestly, I've never done this kind of thing before until this past few months, and it was kind of getting on my nerve. I think many people just push themselves trying to do everything really fast and do all the things at once, but that's not a very healthy path to go on for either physical or mental health, and I don't wanna do that ever. The main reason I started my YouTube channel was to keep my mind off of things that are happening in real life. I thought it would be a good distraction just to do what I love most, which is art, and share them with people who might be inspired to do art for themselves. So it's really ironic that this plan has started to backfire on me, as it became another source for anxiety. Please note that I'm using past tense here. I'm not feeling that way now. So to rectify the situation, I took some weeks off to just paint and draw without the stress of filming or editing it, and created a weekly schedule to paint and study, which I've never done in my life. Generally, I'm a very messy person. Actually started with a new medium, which is colored pencil, and it was really refreshing. I've always been terrified of this medium. Whenever I try to draw a landscape or a portrait with colored pencils, it would just become a mess. I'm really crappy at them. So seeing a lot of tutorials about how the blending works or how to properly use them, I'm getting a little bit comfortable with using color pencils. Sure, we'll share some of my learning process with you guys in the future, and I still think they're very hard to use, and what I learned recently is that it takes a lot of time and a lot of patience with color pencils. I think it can be said about drawing in general, but with color pencils I think it takes a really long time. And honestly, I think I don't have the patience for it. So let's see. But I really love doing art. It's always been my favorite thing to do. So I'm going to keep at it with learning different medium or learning new skills. So let's see how that goes. So back with the current painting process that I'm showing you guys. I think I started to work on this piece on March 29th, and it took an hour just to sketch the outline, then a couple of more sitting over the weeks to finally finish it. I mean, there are so many details in this picture. I don't know why I keep doing this. I mean, every time I choose a reference picture, it always with so many details that it becomes really frustrating to finish it in one sitting. And I always tell myself next time I will sure pick something very simple. So let's see if that ever happens. And let me know if you guys like to paint or draw simple scenery or detailed one, as I'm always choosing the hard ones. And what medium do you use most? I really love using gouache. I think it's my favorite medium so far, after watercolors of course, And I've been painting with watercolors for almost 10 years now. So far, it's always been my favorite. And I like the transparency of the watercolors, because with it the picture tend to look so crisp and refreshing. I just love that. But gouache is so much easier to handle because it's really opaque and easy to correct any mistakes. For this reason, I think gouache is really great for beginners. So these past few days I've been painting more and more fantasy kind of scenery, and normally I just paint portraits, but I'm finding it very therapeutic to recreate this dreamy landscape. And all of this painting looks so cohesive in the sketchbook, all at the same place. Oh, and by the way, I noticed a sudden rise in my subscriber count. So a huge thank you to all of my new subscribers who are watching my content. It really inspires me a lot to keep doing what I love. I know it's not a huge number, but it means a lot to me. So I really appreciate it. So this is the final look. hope you guys enjoyed the painting process. If you're still watching and enduring my rambling, thank you so much, and see you in my next video. Bye.